I get excited that people still come out to theater. I get excited that there's a community of people here willing to support a theater, come out and hear a group of people gather together and tell them a story.
There's something really specific about this community that has come around Yellow Tree that gets me really excited. The passion that people show for Yellow Tree and just the passion in general that this community brings into this venue is just inspiring, and I love to be here.
The first time I met Jason, I sat down and talked with him. I said, the thing that I love most about your theater is your audience. And that remains true.
I think the Yellow Tree Theater takes risks within its community. They do shows that everyone would recognize, and they do shows that no one has ever heard of, and that is exciting.
When you walk into the building for the first time and you walk down the hallway and you come through the doors, you're not really expecting to find what you find, which is this magical, warm, delightful place. And I think people's expectations begin right there when they realize that they can really expect the unexpected here.
What someone can expect the first time they come to Yellow Tree is, I think, to be surprised. They drive up to the parking lot, first of all, and they're kind of like, what is this place? It's a strip mall on the outside, and it's a very strange place to have a theater. But they walk down the hall, and then they walk into Yellow Tree, and I love to look at their faces because they're surprised at from the lobby to, you know, the tree and the wine bar, and then they walk into the theater, and it's just a very unexpected place to have a theater, and it's fun to surprise people.
Highway 81 is not the Great White Way, like Broadway, but once you've found the theater, which isn't too hard, you are welcomed with an atmosphere of excitement, fun, anticipation of something interesting, and with quality.
Because doing theater in Osseo is not like doing theater anywhere else. You're in more of a suburban community. Your audience is usually a lot of times people who may have never been to theater before, and you have the ability to make a difference, and that's what's exciting.
We're in a town with 2,400 people in it, and we have a thriving artistic community. We like to do plays that are quirky, a little off the wall, plays that tell a good story. We want to tell stories that have been told for hundreds of years and stories that have never been told before. I think there's a place for both of them.
You can be sitting on your grandpa's knee hearing him tell you a story, or you can be in a theater having people tell you stories. It's the oldest art there is. It's a way of communicating.
When I think about the importance of storytelling, and I often remind my students of this, I really go back to the idea that just as a society, we're a people of storytellers. And theater is the most truthful, honest, emotional, direct way to tell a really good story.
Telling stories is important because it's our legacy. It's the only real thing that we leave behind, and I think it's important to invest in that.
There's never been a time in the history of the world when almost all art forms, but especially theater, has not been in some way subsidized or helped.
Theater cannot happen without the support of its community, whether that's coming out to see a show, whether that's volunteering, whether that's giving money. Theater cannot happen without that. And I think it's really important that we have a place that we can gather together and connect and get away from our daily lives and come hear a story.
I think it's wonderful that a community like Osseo or the Northwest, part of the Twin Cities, has embraced this organization, this little artistic effort, with such enthusiasm and heart.
Giving to Yellow Tree Theater is important because it's not just an investment in the arts, it's an investment in the community.
I think that theater can be a hugely positive impact in a local community, whether they're going out to restaurants or shopping beforehand. And I think this community has seen that, and they've been very supportive of that. When we first walked in here, there was four white walls. Jessica and I looked at each other and we said, yeah, we can do theater here. And from that moment on, we haven't looked back. We said, you know, we're going to take this little strip mall and we're gonna turn it into a vibrant, artistic venue. And that's what we've done.